My favorite aspect of Wrecking Ball is how high skill his mobility is, and because of that, how much impact you can have in terms of like personally like surviving.
因为这个英雄，我感觉他的就是可玩性特别高，非常玩起来非常有乐趣。最喜欢的就是他这个就是爪钩，就没有空间能限制他这个机动能力。
但 Wrecking Ball이민선이랑비슷하게쿨타임베이스인히어로인것같고요아무래도막이속도빠르고막되게전장을누빌수있는영웅이다보니까하다보면재밌는것같아요
So again, Wrecking Ball, the thing that sets him apart is he's just very, very self-sustainable. You don't really, your team doesn't like need to worry about you too much. It's not, your like healers aren't going to be like really like struggling to like heal the rest of your team because you have that Wrecking Ball. He's very self-sufficient.
他没有盾可以保护队友，就是没有一个盾牌，就像莱因哈特那样盾牌去保护队友。但是他可以用自己的身体去帮队友扛伤害，或者说。因为他在输出能力上更强，就通过打，就是通过击杀敌人来保护队友。
Bowling for Swedes, and Aman aces that one off the edge as the Vic goes flying. Gonna stay in control here.
보통 CC 길을가진영웅들이오리사나호그같은되게느리고약간정적인영웅들이었는데레킹볼이이게파이드라이버가엄청좋은 CC 인데도불구하고그렇게빠른영웅이다보니까그런뭐
Obviously, maps with like lots of environmental places to go for environmental kills are obviously always going to be really good. I really like him on Temple of Anubis. That's a map that stands out to me. There's just lots of pillars, and like when you have like a very, very high understanding of like his movement abilities, it's like on second point, it's actually kind of crazy the things you can do because with the pillars all in different places and stuff.If you know exactly how to control like how long his grapple will be and like the length of the grapple, you're able to like weave in between pillars and stuff, and it's like really, it's like shows how high skill the character can be on that map.
그리고그좋은이훅그스팟같은거는유신폭도에서그힐포에그엄청높은그간판있잖아요왕관모양그거있잖아
잘모르
겠어요 아무튼그왕관모양간판이있는데거의다훅을하면은이제그높이올라갈수있으면서파이드라이버각도계속해
因为丽江塔很适合球去利用它的撞击去地形杀，就很容易造成地形杀。
I'd say the biggest thing when trying to learn his grapple is learning like where on walls you should grapple because like obviously if you want to travel horizontally quickly, you should be grappling like lower to the wall so you can like pull yourself.And if you want to be going for like height and like be able to weave through the sky, you can grapple like really, really high on walls and go wide, and it'll allow you a lot more fluid movement in the air.
我觉得最有价值的是跟队友打 combo， 就是跟队友去配合，比如跟盲妹的大招去配合，当然这是最合理的。
교차되는거는솔직히그총쏠때말고는거의그렇게다녀야일단이속도빠르고뭐맞는면적도아마좀적을것같은데헤드도없고예그러다보니까
파이어本身的弱点我觉得是
Sombra.
너그거나그거랑그해킹당하면그폭도안되고교차도안되기때문에솜브라가없고요
I'd say his biggest weakness is he doesn't really have a lot of cleave damage outside of the pile drive. So if the enemy team is playing grouped up, and you know that's like a very common thing right now in GOATs, it's really hard to like single out certain targets because of the just the nature of GOATs, you wanting to like, be stacked up and stuff.
而且他给不了队友很多的保护，他的进攻性是比较强的，所以他选出他的时候，就他的队友可能会。比较难受，因为没有盾牌去保护的队友。
Oh man, now you have to stay on this point. You're not allowed to leave, and that is it. The hunters, they're gonna do it.
他因为他是没有盾牌的英雄，所以他很怕控制技能，就比如说小美的减速，或者说安娜的睡帧和技能，就是尽量的避开他们，或者说用队友的帮助。最常见就是在自己没有 E 技能。没有 E 技能的时候，依然去 去滚进人群中。
A general rule of thumb with your minefield, you want to be able to make sure that you have your pile drive off cooldown when you minefield, because like honestly, it's like 99% of the time when you use your minefield, you need to follow it up with a pile drive because it knocks them up, CCs them a short period of time, and it gives the bombs time to prime. Most importantly.